you really want to keep yourself looking natural.
Denise specializes in makeup and hairstyling for media and live events.
I decided that I was going to try and give makeup a shot. I went and did a knockoff glamour shots in the mall. I started working there.
How can makeup enhance their professional image during interviews or photo sessions? Welcome to Mastery Podcast, where we explore the art of living fully, balancing mind, body, spirit, and passion in pursuit of a better world. I am your host, Dr. Sass. Today, we welcome Denise Hutter, the talent behind Images by Denise. With over 30 years of experience, Denise specializes in makeup and hairstyling for media and live events. Her expertise lies in creating natural, camera-ready looks that enhance the professional image of entrepreneurs and individuals in the public eye. Welcome, Denise. It's actually so fun for you to be here today.
Oh, well, thank you. I appreciate you having me, and it's wonderful to meet you. And I love working with you. She is the most beautiful woman that I I feel your energy.
Thank you. Thank you, Denise. And Denise has been here for the past 2 days working with Mastery Podcast and with our guests. You're amazing. You transform people to help them feel more confident and to look their best. And you don't make them look any different than their beautiful self. You just enhance what they have. And we're just like, oh my gosh, thank you, Denise. Thank you, Denise. We're just so blessed that you're here today.
Oh, thank you. I feel like I am also.
Thank you. I'm glad you do. How did you get into hand makeup, Denise?
Well, I mean, my choice was actually to go into art school. My sister had gone to FIT before me, and my mother was an artist, but she was also a hairdresser. And it seemed like it was pretty much a normal path to follow. But my mom got sick when I was just a few months into my 18th year. And what happened was that college was no longer in the picture for me. So I was fortunate enough to be honored with a scholarship from Austin's Beauty School, which is where my mother went to school. And they were gracious enough to go and give me a scholarship. And that was what started me on the path. It was a long time ago, and it was something that was really hard to deal with as a teenager and growing adult. I never felt complete.
I can imagine.
It was shortened my time with my mom. I had so much more to learn.
Right.
I'm still learning lessons that I think she would have taught me.
Right. But you've become this wonderful, wonderful makeup artist. I think the experiences that life gave us, right? You can either take it and make it beautiful, or you can just go in the corner and cry, and you make something beautiful out of your experience. And thank God you took that opportunity to go to the beauty school.
It's funny because I never actually finished that school. I had enough education. I did work a little bit, but it wasn't, I was mostly in the restaurant and bar world. And it wasn't until I met my husband quite a while later that I decided to go back and get my license completed, because being married and working in bars and restaurants wasn't the best place for me. When I found out I was too tall, really, to wash hair, that I decided that I was going to try and give makeup a shot. I went and did a knockoff glamour shots in the mall. I started working there, and I loved it. It was so fun. It was so creative. People all of a sudden wanted to have me do their weddings. They wanted to pay me outside of this business. And I started doing that. All of a sudden, one day I came home and I looked at my husband and I said, I am now a makeup artist. And from that moment on, that's what I became. And I have the coolest job in the world.
You do. And I bet you meet so many celebrities. And I know not too long ago, you were preparing someone for Oscar and stuff like that.
Yes, I meet people from all different walks of life. I have people who are billionaires. I have people who are heads of company, politicians that I help get ready for whatever their events are. I also work on people who are unhoused to tell their story, because that's what I do. I help tell the story. I visually put, with my art, I'm able to go and do hair and makeup to help tell anyone's story.
Denise, in the context of business owners, right, and entrepreneurs who are in front of camera, right, they have to make videos, and, you know, it's society now that we, as a business owner, you have social media handle, you take pictures and all this stuff, and we do interviews. And how can makeup enhance their professional image during interviews or photo sessions?
When I'm hired, it's usually a couple of different things. I'm either hired by a single client, or I'm hired by a photo studio or a communications studio. And depending on their project, if there's a lot of people, I am mostly going in and I'm just going to look for, to mat them down and wrangle hair. And sometimes that's it, or give them the talent's own makeup that they come with, a little bit of a zhuzh. And that's fine. And that works really well, especially if I'm working with larger groups. If I am hired to come in and do one person, I will go and do everything, and I will try to make her comfortable. If I'm able to work with her beforehand, I can set her up with her own makeup kit. That way I can come back and she'll have everything she needs when she's not with me. But I will stay on set. I will make sure that the continuity goes and works. What people don't understand when they see people on shows is that there's somebody like me that is making sure that your hair isn't sticking up, that you're not getting shiny, that you don't have little beads of sweat over your lip. Mm-hmm. That's not because they look perfect all the time. That's because there's somebody over there to blot it down.
And especially when you're recording something like this, you want to look your best.
Well,
right?
I did the right thing. By bringing me here today, I was able to go and give people little tips. I mean, just the simplest things. If you can go and grab a primer that will make sure that you're matte or that you're moist, depending on if you have dry skin versus oily skin. Mm-hmm. Just by figuring out little ways of getting to go and calm your hair down.
Right.
It's those are two tips that can bring you really far. And especially for men. Men don't think they wear makeup on television. Well, if there's a camera in front of you, you need to have makeup. Right. Because otherwise you're going to look slimy. Nobody's going to buy anything from the slimy people.
Right. Denise, and you're different. You truly stand out in your field. I visited your website, and what struck me is your exceptional expertise in natural makeup application, not just for women, but for men as well. You really cater to the diverse needs of media and live events. So your high-definition makeup skills, Denise, are top-notch. You make sure that everyone looks their absolute best on camera. Your portfolio speaks volume, from high-profile clients to being featured in well-respected publications. It's clear you bring a level of professionalism and creativity that make you just a great asset to any project.
I enjoy that. I may be just more experienced than some. Being that I've worked at this for a long time, it gives me that ability. And I'm happy to say that someone my age is more educated and worthwhile because of it. And not instead in, you know, younger people. I bring a lot of people up and I mentor some of the younger artists. I love working in a team. I have some really good assistants who I would actually send on jobs also, because they are just as good as I am. But I haven't put as many years in.
What are some of the key makeup tips for entrepreneurs to maintain their brand identity on camera?
Well, of course, my favorite tip is, you're going to be on screen. You really need someone like me who has your back, who's going to go and tell you when you have a hair out of place and fix you, because you don't know what's happening at the time.
Right.
So having someone standing back and able to do that is worth the money.
Definitely. I see this 2 days you've been with us. I've seen the value in having a professional like you around, especially when you want to record training video or an interview and having a photo shoot session.
I love it when I see commercials that I did. A lot of times I don't realize I did it until I go, that sounds so familiar. Because if you've ever seen something taped, they take it over and over and over and over and over again.
Right.
So I tend to get to learn the words.
The script.
Yeah. Then I go, oh yeah, there's my work.
Yeah.
Look at that on the TV. You'd never know it was me, which is okay.
Yeah. Can you share examples of how the right makeup has helped people convey their brand and their story effectively?
Well, it's the right makeup is specific to each person. So you do want to have them show who they are, not who I make them up to be. So when I work with people, I like to go and spend enough time with them to find out a little about them. And if they're going to feel uncomfortable in my makeup and hair. So if they don't feel comfortable and beautiful, they're not going to represent themselves well. Products in general, like I said, some powder, a little lip, little color on your cheekbones. It doesn't have to be a lot. It just has to be enough to go and be able to see your eyes. I think one of the biggest tips that I can think of recently, because eyelashes have become a really big, everyone's wearing them.
Right.
And eyelashes are great. It will accentuate your eyes and make them pop. But if you go too heavy on a lash, it will shade them and you won't be able to get any light in your eyes. And that will make you look dark or not there, absent. You don't want to go and do that. You don't want to portray yourself as not being soulless.
Right.
But I have these huge lashes.
Right.
Another trend is dewy. Mm-hmm. And dewy is great. I love dewy. It looks more like natural skin. But sometimes dewy, if it gets away from you, can be slimy or oil slick. And that's never attractive. So you have to be very careful when you go with anything that is shimmery, highlighted. You really want to keep yourself looking natural. And
right.
That's why I said just the minimum of product is probably the best way to go. And if you can reach out to a professional who has actually worked in television and ask them to go and help you build a makeup kit and show you how to apply it, that's going to be your best bet and probably your most cost-effective if you can't have them standing on set.
Right. That's a great idea. And do you do that for entrepreneurs?
I do that for anybody. I do have times when I am asked just to go and give a makeup lesson. I had a lady who just had a baby who asked me that. She came in for pictures, actually, and I did her makeup. And she got home and she says, what foundation did you use on me? Mm-hmm. What did you use on my eyes? How did you make my mouth look like that? And I told her the next time she comes in, thought we could spend some time and I'll explain to her what I did and I will make it in a way that she could understand it and that she could take notes. And it's not brain surgery.
And it's nice that there are, you know, people like you where if they are willing to learn for the everyday look, you know, being on the set is one thing. And everyday look where they want to look their best, you know, they out there meeting people, they out there leading the team, and they just want to feel good because you are your best when you feel good. If you travel, I know you travel for your work. How far have you traveled?
California, New York, all of North Carolina, Virginia. I will go anywhere.
A lot of people are going to see you from other state. And if they wondering, oh, will she come to Texas? Will she go to, Salt Lake
Paris.
City?
I will go to Paris. It'll be tough. I only know a little bit of French. But yeah, I'll go.
Yeah, I'll take you to Switzerland with me.
Wonderful. I love Switzerland.
Yeah, my husband is from there, so we go there a lot. Oh. And it's beautiful there. And we would take pictures, and I was just like, wow. You know, and it just come to my mind right now. It would be great to have, like, professional there to take professional pictures because where we go, it just amazing views, just amazing.
Wow, yeah.
Yeah.
A part of Switzerland.
Lucerne.
Oh, Lucerne is beautiful.
It's gorgeous.
Yes.
Y'all, if that is not on your bucket list, please go.
Yes, it's absolutely beautiful.
It is absolutely gorgeous. It's like a fairy tale city.
Well, I was only there for a couple of nights, but I was staying in Schaffhausen, so mostly in the German area.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was lovely.
Really beautiful. Well, thank you so much, Denise,
thank
for
you.
Being
it's
here.
So wonderful being
yeah.
here.
Yeah, thank you for your advice and all your expertise. We're just happy to have you here with us today.
Thanks.
Beautiful. Thank you. Got lashes.
Yeah. Are they weird?
I normally don't have lashes.
Fresh hair is nice because it's clean, but...
Yeah.
Like lasagna, hair is better the second day.
Now you look camera ready. This is what you want to do when you want to be camera ready.
There we go.
You know, just pack the needs.
That's the secret. And you did a fantastic job. I really like your makeup, everything you've done about it.
Always a lot of proof.
Oh yeah, this is life. There's not better than getting pampered.
With her hair, when she first came in, it was just standing on end. First thing I did was I put hand cream on my hands, and a little tiny bit of oil will help lay down some of the fine flyaways. And this product is a very inexpensive hairspray that I actually love because it doesn't look heavy. I spray it into my hand because I don't want it getting onto the camera lenses.
Yeah.
Aerosols will tend to do that, and it doesn't smell bad. It smells clean to me. It's something I've been using forever.